This is quite a climb. I have to get higher to try and pinpoint Silga's signal. Looks like I have company.
I'm here.
Still need to climb higher. Okay, now to pick up the signal. Where's the best spot? I should try to find a good spot to pick up Silga's message. Getting stronger. My focus almost has where it's coming from. Time to pay that Tanakh Tower a visit. Bet I'll get a nice view if I glide down from here. Here is sick with blight too, but we'll be able to heal all of it once Guy is strong enough to capture Hephaestus. The machine riders from before, the ones who were racing, wonder what they're up to.
I won the race. Hey,
You threw a rock in my face.
It's not like you...
I wonder what they used all these machines for.
Use of this.
Of the old world. Looks like some kind of tower surrounded by panels. Looks like I'm higher up than where the image was taken. That ancient lookout might be a good spot to try to line up the image.
Ah!
chance.
On to me.
Tower should help me pinpoint Silda's signal.
Come on.
Gotta climb up to look for Silga's signal. But where... Keep climbing to pinpoint that signal. Just a little higher. Almost there. Okay, let's see if I can pick up Silga's signal.
Stark 142 to Enduring Victory, Reno. Supply drop beacon echo. Pull. I'm trying to get this safely. I left a note for you inside.
There. Found the signal's origin. It's not too far from here. I just need to get to it. I could try to line up the vista point image again. I should be within range. Plasma ammo isn't gonna do much. teach me. Is it enough? Some kind of drone. Is it watching over this area? Might have some useful data. But how to get up there? Gotta bring the drone down to grab its data. Maybe if I jump onto it? Farther than I thought. Do I have any fire ammo on me? My focus is picking up the signal that Silga found. The machines before I can look for the source. acid will eat right through that metal. My focus is picking up the signal with Silverfoot. I'll need to clear up the machines before I can look for the source.
Thank you.
to get to you. But I'll need to deal with these machines first. Find my way to the signal source. way. I should search for another way in. Promising? Right. Into the water. Silga will want to know about this. And she'll definitely be interested in the transmitter inside that's been sending the message.
Aloy, the word stopped coming from the spike. What happened?
This is what was speaking to your rig. It's old world equipment used for communicating over long distances. The message must have shut off when I took it, but I heard the note the voice was talking about.
What was it?
During an ancient war, a woman was trying to deliver supplies to a man she knew. She wanted him to know that their past disagreements didn't matter in the big picture. That she'd be thinking of him when the end came.
Oh. I guess she and I are kin of a sort. I wish I could give my brother a message like that. Tell him that I forgave him. He would have wanted that. I know. This man, the old one, did he ever hear the message? gets often in the way of it then. But still, with the power of that device you found, the sender had hope that he might have heard it. What a feat! To send messages, near and far. Can I keep this? It's a treasure.
Of course.
Thank you. Sometimes, people don't ever get to hear what they should. But with this thing, maybe I can get them talking to one another. From Mainspring, all the way to who knows where.
Hey, I found a few more things in the supply cache. Might be able to make something out of them. Can I use your workbench?
Sure. Yeah, right over there. Anytime, Aloy. It's all yours.
I think I know just what to do with these parts. That turned out well. Can't wait to try it.
Champion killer. Well met.
Oh, you came. I'm touched.
You'll have to excuse the mess. Our soldiers use this place to prepare themselves before herding machines into the canyon and harvesting parts. Feel free to take any supplies you need. Our prey isn't far.
I'm right behind you.
This way. The sooner we get those machine hearts, the faster we'll get the water we need. Can't believe an outlander would lend us a hand when our own clan won't. Our so-called commander's always talking about how scarce water is in the desert. But do you really think anyone in Scalding Spear is dying of thirst? Or her own squad? Our clan should be led by someone who knows what it's like to fight tooth and nail to survive.
And I'm guessing that someone is you?
Make sure everyone gets all the water they need. No matter what village they're from.
Didn't Jataka say you guys have too little to go around to begin with?
We're here.
I'll help you harvest machine hearts if it'll get water for your people.
Oh, we will. That's the canyon we draw machines into. Then we block them in and pick them off. Now, we'll have to climb over the barricade to get in. When we do, be ready to fight. I already lost good people in there. Can't wait to see the champion killer in action. You go and I'll follow.
Thank you.
parts we need. I should take these to Draka. I can get it for my stash later.
May the wings of the Ten carry you home, my brother.
I got the hearts. We should head back to Arrowhand.
Yeah. At least now we can bag and tag these soldiers. Oh, hold on. Since you can clearly handle a bunch of angry machines, I want to go back to where the Thunderjaw hit us. I lost a lot more fighters there. I can't just leave them to rot. They deserve to be bagged and tagged too. Will you come with me?
Lead the way.
Glad to have you along. Think so many have to die just to get water.
Did you try talking to your commander with Scalding Spear?
Please, the only thing she'll listen to is the sound of a bow being drawn. About that, wouldn't mind having yours at my side if it ever came to it.
I'm just passing through, Draka.
You can't blame me for trying. This is it. Where the Thunderjaw ripped through my squad.
I'm sorry, Draka.
They were warriors to the end. We should get started.
Someone's alive. By the rocks.
The ground.
Speak sense, soldier.
Burrowers.
Thunderjaw's back. This is gonna get rough.
Not gonna back down.
Ravagers around. We can use their cannons! dead raptors. Use them against the Thunderjaw.
Cannons! Off the dead raptors. Use them against the Thunderjaw.
cannons off those ravagers. Give myself some firepower. Off those ravagers. Get myself some firepower.
Do me a favor and get the Thunderjaw's heart. I need to check on that soldier.
Well, this'll do. I should check on Draka and that soldier.
Maybe in a minute.
Didn't think I was going to make it.
You did good, soldier. You're going back home. Thanks to this one.
You were the one who refused to leave your people behind.
I know I'm racking up favors here, but, did you take those hearts back to Arrowhand? We'll be right behind you.
Of course. Be careful.
With that Thunderjaw heart in hand, we'll get all the water we need. Thank you, Aloy.
Dust haze. Storm's on its way.
Appreciate the extra pair of hands.
You've returned. Where's Draka?
Just a little late, Chaplain. Gained some extra baggage on the way back. She's got the machine hearts, including a Thunderjaws. You should have seen this flame in the desert. Here. Something to commemorate our heroic victory.
A victory indeed. Command will be relieved to hear about this.
Get them to Scalding Spear as soon as you can. And tell the commander how many had to die to get them.
Huntress, may I have a word? Rumors have made their way west. They say that in addition to your bow and spear, you have a kind of second sight, especially for matters that have to do with the old ones.
That's one way to put it.
So it's true. You've done well by my clan, but our troubles may not be as easily settled as Draka believes. I think your second sight might be just what we need.
What exactly is the problem?
Not here. Meet me at Scalding Spear. I'll explain everything.
I'll see you there when I can.
Good. The entire clan might depend on it.
Outlander, will you trade with the Tanakh?
Gather these while I can. Getting close to Aether's location. Guy said it would be in some kind of physical processor. Ancient ruin turned into a Tanakh stronghold. Could Aether be inside? Poking around's not going to be easy with Tanakh's warriors everywhere.
soldiers killed since.
Regala's forces may seem strong now, but...
her machines took out my entire squad.
Remember the visions. The old ones didn't choose their fight, but still, they stood firm. They didn't falter. And neither were we. Blood of the Ten. You've come to us.
You know who I am?
Oh, the warrior with hair like wildfire who defeated Regala's champion at Baron Light. Yes, you are known to us. I am Dekka, chaplain of the Lolan clan. You've come to speak with Chief Hikaru.
Not quite. There's something I need here.
Anything you need, the chief will provide. Come.
Is that one of the visions you were talking about?
Yes. The records of the Ten. I can show you them, if you like. On the way to the chief.
These visions, you said they're the records of the Ten. Who are they?
Old ones. Who fought a heroic battle against machines on this very soil long ago. Their deeds are honored in the visions. At least what remains of them. To be remembered and exalted.
There used to be more of these visions?
Many more. Once this place was filled with light and sound. But over the years, they've fallen into darkness. One by one. That is why chaplains are so important to the tribe. We remember all we can of the visions. Etched in our flesh. Passed down by word of mouth from generation to generation. One day the whole grove may go dark. But chaplains who come after me will keep the memories alive.
What does it mean to be a chaplain here?
We who outlast our youth study the visions and share their wisdom with our young.
What kind of wisdom?
How to be a true warrior. To fight with bravery and unflinching honor. And to know when to call for peace. You can see for yourself.
Why does Hikaru want to see me?
We are at war with Regala. And you've already shown that you can...
I'm not here to fight a war for you.
Not for us. With us. But I won't try to persuade you. That is for the chief.
All right.
He's in his throne room. Come.
Come, soldier of Ten.
It's glitched. Incomplete.
Their full truths are lost to us. It's a chaplain's duty to make sense of these visions as best we can.
Led by Kamran, the British chaplains were on the battle.
The Ten were dedicated soldiers, working together as a squad and sharing in their duty. And when the time came for battle, they took to the skies and leaped to glory. All Tanakh seek to follow their example. Before the chief, it was one of the few things the clans had in common. During their war, the Ten climbed sheer rock, braving blinding snow and wind. They stopped at nothing to protect their own.
You make them sound invincible.
They weren't. But the visions tell us of their courage and strength. Something our soldiers aspire to. The Sky Clan admires this one above all the rest. They make their home in the mountains northwest of here.
What's this one about?
The Ten waged war against their enemy in the desert heat, a land too harsh for any to survive. But against all odds, they prevailed. So the Desert Clan does the same. You must have passed through their territory on the way here.
I did. They seem a little extreme.
They take that as a compliment.
Soldiers in a jungle. Those were the Ten?
Yes. They knew how to use the jungle's depths to distract the enemy until the perfect moment to strike. Generations ago, my clan, the Lowland, looked to this one for inspiration as they claimed the jungle to the southwest.
Hey, Outlander. It said that relic you wear.
You have an old world recording?
This box was speaking with voices of the old ones. But now there's noise over them.
Let me take a look. Where did you find this?
We took it from an Oseram Delver. She was trying to steal it, and other artifacts from Tanakh's territory. The others were going to bury it in the sand with her. But then I heard the voices.
Well, the data here is badly corrupted, but...
Delta Juliet 9, you are weapons free and clear to engage the swarm. Good hunting.
Copy that. We'll buy Zero Dawn the time you need. Delta Juliet 9 out.
The voices of warriors from the past. And that Oseram wanted to sell them for shards. The bravery of the Ten should be remembered.
I'm not sure what you mean by the Ten. These voices came from the final battle of the Old Ones.
Another battle? I could learn more about it if I could find the other boxes. That Delver did say there might be more recordings to be found in the wreckage of ancient flying machines. She claimed she had a way to locate them.
Yeah. The box with the voice data on it is emitting a locator signal. I could use it to find the others.
If you do, then, bring them back here. I will see to it that they're treated with proper respect. Whatever sacrifices were made by these ancient soldiers, we will honor them.
I've already found a recording.
I'll take any you find. Let me give you something for it. These voices will be kept here. They will be remembered.
Do you get many?
Fewer every time we catch, but those thieving rats would do anything for the ship. There'll always be some who'll risk...
And what do you do with the...
Delvers spend their lives in the... So we bury them in it.
Why do you want these...
Every battle teaches its soldiers. We should honor those who fell.
If I find...
Join us, Student 10. Deep in the ring.
My focus can detect beacons from those recording devices. Should help me to find any others that are still out there.
The chief is inside. Are you ready to see him?
I'm ready.
Good. Come.
Underneath the throne.
I will see you soon, Outlander.
The Savior of Meridian. I am told you held back Regala's forces outside Baron Light. And defeated her champion, Grutta, in single combat. Impressive.
I met Fashav there, too. He said you were a great warrior. And a man of honor.
His death is a painful loss among many. we will not soon recover from the massacre of our marshals. But if you are here to pledge your service, that could help considerably.
I am not here to fight for you. I need something in that basement. Something that will save many lives, yours included. It's not something you can see, but it is there.
I have seen it. You have named your price. Now I name mine. With my marshals dead, I need your spear. Help me defeat my enemies, and I will grant you access to the chamber below.
I don't have a price. I am not a hired killer. I'm here to save lives, more than you can count.
I count the corpses of marshals slain. I count hundreds more to knock them, whose lives hang in the balance. I will fight for them. I will kill anyone who threatens the peace, and you will too, if you want me to open the door to the chamber below.
Okay. So by that logic, what's stopping me from killing you right now, and taking what I need to save everyone?
You could try. You might even succeed. Either way, you must fight. My way might hold off Regala and the slaughter she craves.
Fine. What do you need?
I need more marshals to keep the tribe together. Such warriors can only be promoted at a trial by combat called the Kulrut. I've sent out a call for the competition. Since Regala seeks to undermine me, she is certain to attack it. She'll want to kill me in front of the assembled clans.
So what, you want me to be your bodyguard?
No. To defend the Kulrut. But there is more. Knowing Regala will attack, one of the clans had balked at sending their contestants. Must go north and force Tecote, the commander of the Sky Clan, to submit and send his best.
Force him to submit?
Do whatever is necessary. I can't hold a Kulrut with two of the three clans in attendance. Marshal Katala will assist you. He was maimed at Baron Light, but he can still be of use. I sent him ahead to the northern village of Stonecrest. Meet him there, and he will guide you to the Sky Clan stronghold. If you have any questions about your mission, now is the time.
You said you saw what's in the basement?
I did, on the day of my greatest victory.
What do you mean?
For a dozen generations, the three clans battled for control of this hallowed ground. Only I achieved it. I fought for years. Killed whoever stood in my way. When I had finally slain all rivals, I stood alone in the grove. Victory was mine to savor, or so I thought. Thunder roared from the east, and a bolt of blue struck this place. That chamber.
Gaia dies, and Aether arrives.
All around me, the visions of the grove grew louder and brighter. And suddenly a new one appeared before me. The old one spoke, and what they said changed everything.
What did the old one say to you in this new vision?
The one called Faraday foretold the growing danger of the machines, and said we must unify to stop them. She called for marshals to enforce the peace. Then the vision faded. Never to be seen again. I marked the spot where it shone with my spear, and I took Faraday's words to heart. Renounced war between the clans, trained warriors to fight machines, ordained marshals through the Kulrut. Since then, the tribe has been at peace, until Regala attacked at Baron Light.
And the chamber beneath the throne. You went in after the vision?
I did. Inside is an ancient device. It hums with power. You will see it for yourself after the Kulrut. This I swear.
Why won't the Sky Clan send contestants to the Cool Root?
Of the three clans, they have the most defensible base, protected by a mighty wall called the Bulwark. Their commander believes he can wait out the war between Regala's forces and my own, safe behind his barrier.
Staying strong, while you and Regala weaken each other.
You think like a seasoned marshal. Good.
Why send me to deal with the Sky Clan?
All Tanath respect strength, and you drove Regala back at Baron Light.
That and most of your marshals are dead?
Correct.
What about Catalo? Can't he do it by himself?
He is maimed. They will no longer respect him.
That hardly seems fair.
What is fair about losing an arm? Whether they respect him or not, Catalo still has worth. He knows the Sky Clan. He was raised in their base. He will guide you well.
What exactly is the Cool Root?
Where once the clans fought each other, now we fight as one, against the machines. That is my law made manifest in the Cool Root. Each clan must send contestants whenever I call for the ritual. These contestants face trial by combat against machines in an arena just beyond these walls. Those who distinguish themselves become marshals who bind the tribe together as peacekeepers.
You called them peacekeepers, but the marshals I met at the embassy were warriors.
Warriors, yes, but more. They renounce the clan that birthed them and pledge themselves to order and peace. They enforce my law. They settle disputes and stand for Tanakh in parley with other tribes. Without them, I cannot rule. Which is why you must ensure the next Cool Root takes place.
Fashav called Regala your greatest mistake. Why?
That is not your concern.
Really? I fought against her forces at Baron Light, and I don't even know what her problem is.
She was the deadliest of my marshals. The point of my spear.
So what happened?
Above all, Regala despises the Karja who burned her younger brothers alive. After we turned back the Red Raids and tore down the battlements of Baron Light, she hoped to chase them all the way to Meridian. She could not see the cost of such a war, nor the benefits of peace after the Mad Sun King fell. When I accepted Avad's entreaties, she went mad, called me traitor, challenged me before the marshals.
What did you do when Regala challenged you?
If you were Tanakh, you would know that such a challenge cannot be refused. It was not easy to subdue her. I bear 7 scars from that fight. The other marshals wanted me to execute her on the spot, but I found I could not sever the bond between us. Her loyalty had been as boundless as her rage, so I spared her. Rather than mercy, she took it as a humiliation. One she will never be free from.
I'm sorry about Fashav. He seemed like a good man.
More than a man. A bridge between Tanakh and Karja. No outlander ever earned our respect as he did. I had hoped he would be my voice in Meridian. That peace with the Karja might become something more.
An alliance?
An exchange. The Karja have much we lack. Our deeds are written in ink upon our bodies. Our memories die with our flesh. But the Karja never forget. Their deeds are written in book and scroll.
You wanted to learn from them?
As I learned from Fashav. He will be missed.
So Regala wants you dead.
She does. But that will not be enough. She won't rest until all 3 clans fall in behind her as she marches on Meridian. Who knows? With machines under her control, perhaps she can raise it to the ground.
It's been tried before.
So I hear.
I'll do what you want and go north to deal with Dakote. But you'd better not forget about our deal.
You will have what was promised, if you succeed. Speak to Decca on your way out. She will arm you for the road ahead.
What it must have been like to fly into battle.
Come, let us speak.
Hikaru said you have something for me?
A weapon to aid your mission. You'll need it for the long road to Stonecrest. Many machines prowl along the way, and our scouts have sighted Regala's rebels in the area.
Machines and rebels. Nothing I haven't faced before.
Indeed. Head north towards the foothills. Ascend its slopes until your legs burn and the chill air catches in your chest. Then you'll know you're in the Sky Clan's domain. Strike true as the Ten, Aloy.
If I'm gonna get Aether, guess I'll have to play along with Hikaru. I'd better meet up with Marshal Catalo at Stonecrest. I'll be faster if I ride a machine. What's this place? Gates are shut. I guess I'll have to come back later. Is not going to help.
walk in honor. So, say the chief gets his way. But...
You wanted to speak to me?
The name's Zalka. Have you heard from up north? From Bleeding Mark?
I'm guessing...
One of the desert's villages. They send their yield of ash blood so the Bereka over there can mark the skin of our soldiers. But it's been a long time since the last supply run.
If you think something happened to them...
Were it up to me. But with everyone fuming about our water rations, the commander can't spare any soldiers.
You mentioned the village up north.
It's a crimson stone that we grind into powder for our ink. Bleeding Mark has the largest supply. Our soldiers there gather and deliver it to us.
Die for water.
Everyone in the clan depends on the wound in the sand for their water. Capital and outlying village alike. But the last delivery of Ashblood was... Our supply is running low. So must be their water. My face paint will strike fear in your enemy.
If I'm out that way...
You have my thing. That's Bleeding Mark. Ask for Kentok or Natika there.
Give less water.
Why put guards around the wound?
You can't just take away our water.
The wound gives less water. Our rations adjust. What's going on?
We know the way of the desert. What's stopping us from taking what we want? And now...
Anyone else want to complain? We're the Desert Clan. We survive with what we have.
Your, commander's not much for hand-holding.
That is not our way. Even less so in her case. Shall we?
Sure. Can't wait.
She's with me.
Draka's not the only one with harsh words for your commander.
The desert has bred survival into our clan's blood. We spit at death and charge into battle. Maybe a little too eagerly.
This is the Outlander conspiring with the dissident Draka.
Demanding water does not make one a dissident, Yara.
Doesn't make Draka a commander either. You should advise him of that. Jataka said you needed help.
Did he now?
Aloy has a unique insight into the ways of the Old Ones. She might be able to fix this before it gets out of hand.
Get to the point. What is Jataka talking about?
There is no water.
What do you mean?
I mean the wound in the sand, that which provides the clan with the water we need to survive, is completely dry.
This water source. Jataka said it's somehow related to the Old Ones?
From what we can tell, whatever water we take, it restores on its own. Over time. A few weeks ago, it stopped. I ordered rationing, searched for other viable sources. But everything else nearby is tainted one way or another.
But why the secrecy? Keeping your...
If the clan knew, my command would be challenged.
There's no water, and you're worrying about keeping your command?
Think what you want. Between the machines, the storms, and Regala's uprising, I'm the only thing keeping this clan from falling apart.
Draka said your clan won't touch Regala.
Her grudge is with Chief Hakaro, not me. And I plan to keep it that way, so her troops don't turn on my clan. Besides, if she defeats Hakaro, she deserves to rule. That's the way of the tribe.
Draka's people sacrificed a lot to get that water. He thinks you're hoarding it for yourself.
The perfect excuse to challenge my command. Like he's always wanted. Of course he makes it sound very noble. That he only cares about his thirsty people. But all he really wants is to be in charge. And if he was, he'd face the exact same problem I have. There is simply not enough water to go around.
So how are you going to deal with not having any water?
Ration what little we have. Buy time to fix the wound.
And in the meantime, people die of thirst?
Every corpse weighs on me. What matters is that the clan survives, as...
I can't promise anything. But if this wound was built by the old ones, I might be able to fix it.
How exactly do you intend to do that?
Just show her the wound, Yara.
Very well. The wound in the sand is this way. You're not Arya, or Oseram.
I was born amongst the Nora, as far east as you are west.
I've heard of your people. They say only those who are exiled leave your lands.
There are exceptions.
What business does a Nora exception have in the west?
Believe it or not, to help people, even the ones who don't want it.
Sounds like a difficult path. This is it. The wound in the sand.
Definitely built by the old ones. Focus should show me more. Pipes. Leading outside the settlement.
What do you see?
A trail.
What are you doing?
Your wound leads underground.
We've tried going down there, but it's too narrow for anyone to reach the bottom. Where are you going?
I think I can lead us to where the water comes from. Or used to.
How?
Doesn't matter.
What matters is that the wound is fixed and my people survive. Lead the way.
Those flowers. The crown's wet, too. The vein must have leaked here. Not enough to be the cause of the missing water, but enough for these plants to grow. We're on the right track.
You see all that from a patch of wet sand?
Yep.
That mound. It looks like the metal from the wound. We really are following its trail.
As I've been saying.
The desert kills. But it also surprises.
That goes past that ridge. We're gonna have to do some climbing.
Nothing we can't handle, I'm sure.
There's a lot of machines.
And a very dead soldier.
One of yours?
I need to take a closer look.
We need to get rid of the machines first. Follow my lead. Get rid of the purge water. You know him?
That is one of Draka's men. I will cut off that dissident's head and feed it to the vultures if he had anything to do with...
We don't know what happened here yet. And we still have a trail to follow.
Lead the way.
Save these for when I need it.
Water. Barely a lick's worth. But there are no streams in this area. These anchors. That soldier must have used them to get up this cliff.
He must have been going back to Arrowhand when those machines got him.
Maybe he found something up there worth reporting back about.
We'll find out soon enough.
What is this?
The problem. I'm gonna need my focus. That weapon. Looks like Draka's man tried to pry this open, but he didn't know what he was doing. And now the water's not going where it's supposed to.
Sabotage.
Or ignorance. I don't think this is gonna do anything. Maybe if I follow that main pipe, I'll find something useful.
What do you need me to do?
Just, stay here. Let me know if anything changes. I'm gonna take a look around. That's the same type of machinery we found outside. Only this one's not leaking. Maybe it can help me switch the water flow. Don't think this will work with water leaking through the other distribution system. That valve I saw earlier. Maybe I can use it to shut off water to those pipes. I'm not getting up through there. A valve. That might help.
Hey, it stopped leaking.
It looks like that stopped the water flow. Now I just need to find a way to get it to Scalding Spear. Sounds like the water switched. Gotta open the valve upstairs. Get that water circulating. Sounds like that did something.
Aloy, I can hear water in the room again.
Anything leaking?
Not that I can see.
Let's hope that means my plan worked. That should do it.
This will return water to Scalding Spear?
Checking the wound is the only way to be sure.
Draka knew what would happen if the capital was left without water. But he didn't care! All he wanted was to cause a crisis so he could challenge my command.
We don't know that for sure.
Meet me back at the wound when you can. Please. To make sure the water will flow.
I will. Don't do anything rash about Draka.
Only an upstart acts rashly. A commander bides her time. Hey. The desert was kind to lead you to us.
Things are about to get ugly between Draka and Yara. Maybe I can head it off.
Thank you.
the extra stock for later. This must be the village Zoka was talking about. It looks like the whole place flooded. Maybe from a recent storm. I wonder if anyone made it out. Best check around the shore. There are a few survivors on that overlook. I should see if they're okay. Is he all right?
He will be. There.
But what about the others?
Let me worry about that. Rest now. I'm Natika. You're a long way from the east, Outlander.
You're Natika. So this must be Bleeding Mark.
What's left of it? How do you know this place?
The Inker's apprentice and Scalding Spear told me to find you. He was worried something happened to your supply caravan.
Well, as you can see, we have more important problems than delivering Ashblood.
What happened here?
The last storm caused a deluge that brought down half of the mountain. The mudslide barreled right through the village. As you heard, we have many missing. But I need to keep watch on these two.
I can take a look around. If I find anyone, I'll send them your way.
Much appreciated. And if you see an older soldier, Grimfaced, goes by Kentok, tell him I'm here.
Will I be able to use my focus to find any survivors? Ugh, the water feels thick. Diluted. Guess this won't help the water shortage and Scalding Spear.
Can anyone hear us?
Where are you?
We're trapped in this tower. Flood blocked the way we came in. There's a ladder at the top, but we can't reach it.
Okay, I'll find a way to get to you.
I need to get to the ladder at the top of the building. Good. Can't use the pull tester on that. It doesn't look like there's a way to swim into the broken building. I need something to get me over the metal wall and inside. There's the ladder on the other building. I can make that jump. It looks like it's stuck. Maybe I can use my weight to make it drop?
No! That was our only way out!
Everyone okay?
You're not one of us. Sorry. Yes.
We took shelter in here when a mudslide swept through the village, but debris blocked the passage we came in through. That ladder was our only way out, but we couldn't reach it from here.
Don't worry. I'll find us another way out of here.
Do you know what happened to the others? Before we ran in here, I thought I saw a few of our comrades climbing up a watchtower on the north side, near the grotto.
I'll look into it. As soon as you're out, head for the shore. Natika's waiting on an overlook there.
So she survived. Good. We'll join her as soon as we have a way out.
Okay. Sit tight for now. Take a step back. How'd she do it?
Okay. You should have a way out.
Thanks. We'll head to the shore in a moment.
It didn't look like Kentok was with this group. Okay. Gotta find this watchtower on the north end. There's another cauldron out there that has override data on that machine.
Hey! Outlander! These machines got us trapped up here. We lost our weapons in the mudslide.
Sit tight! I'll take care of them!
Those boulders. Break the support beam, crush the machines. Well, this isn't gonna do much.
Huh!
those boulders. Break the support beam, crush the machines.
The boulders! Shoot the support beam!
No good.
Is everyone okay?
Better now, without Snapmaws prowling around. You sure know how to fight. We saw some of our comrades stuck on the eastern cliffs. They could use a hand too, if you're willing.
Okay, I'll check it out. Have you seen Kentok? Natika asked me to keep an eye out for him.
Last I saw him was before the mudslide hit.
Okay. Head for the shore, on the other side of the village.
Wounded up here. Need an easy way down. And fast!
Hold on. I'll figure something out. I need to find a way for the Tanox to get down from the cliff. That big crane could help. If I can get it into the right position, I could make a bridge for them. Maybe I can clear it if I pull that beam out. I must be stuck on something else. Underwater, maybe. My focus can help me search. Maybe my focus can help here. Caster won't work on that.
There's no ammo for this. Gliden? Okay, crane's in place. Now, how to lower it to reach the cliff. I should take a look at the bottom of the crane's arm. See if there's a way to move it. It should remove the counterweight and lower the arm. There we go! Oh, damn it. Arm's stuck on something. I better climb up and take a look. Those cables. The arm should drop the rest of the way.
Blood of the Ten. How'd you manage to do that? I don't know how you did it, but thanks for the rescue.
Is everyone okay?
His leg snapped against some debris as we were making a run for it, but he'll live.
How'd you get stuck up here?
A mudslide tore through the village in the last storm. This ledge was just above the flood when we got to it. By the time everything calmed down, the water had receded, leaving us stranded, and we couldn't leave a fellow soldier behind.
Can you make it to the shore from here? Natika's there, tending to the wounded.
Natika. Thank the Ten. We'll head for her location. She'll know what we should do next. Thanks again, Outlander.
Okay. I think that's it for survivors. But I didn't see Kentok among them. I should head back to Natika. I don't know.
Going down!
Rest now. Aloy, thanks to you, these soldiers are safe. But where's Kentok?
I didn't see anyone who matched his description. Do you know where he was when the storm hit?
I was the last one to see him, just before. I told him I wanted to leave this place to pledge my blade to the chief's guard, but he refused to discharge me from the squad. All Tanakh are stubborn fighters, but Kentok is more so than most. So I walked out. I was coming back from the opposite ridge when I saw the mudslide.
You were coming back to make amends.
I must find him. If anyone can survive such a storm, it's him.
You said Kentok.
I've trained under him ever since I was assigned to a squad. He's tough as a shell snapper. But my blade. And he taught me.
To serve something great.
Yes. Rather than fulfilling a greater purpose with the chief's.
You said you wanted to play. Is that what the marshal?
No. The marshals travel the breadth of the clan lands. The guard remains at the grove to defend it and the chief. But like the marshals, only a handful are chosen.
So why did.
He claimed that the greater honor was. But all we do. How can that compare to.
So a mudslide did all this?
We've had more and more of them over the last few years. Torrential rain, lightning strikes, winds that rattle the metal towers. But this last one was the worst yet. This area used to be as arid as the rest of the desert. The storms have changed all that.
There's a water shortage in the capital. Could this help?
The wound in Asan is low? Guess we're not the only ones dealing with problems. But unfortunately, no. This water's poisoned by ash blood. Undrinkable as machine oil.
I can take another look around the village.
Natika.
I'm here.
Where's Kentok?
We're going to find him.
He saved me. Pushed me out of the way as everything collapsed. But then the flood took him. Towards the gouge.
The gouge?
It's an ancient passage that leads deep underground. Come, I'll show you.
Natika, we need orders. We're exposed out here. Only half of us can hold a blade if machines come.
What do you want us to do?
Go. The gouge is in the hillside. Northwest of here. I'll catch up when I can.
What are we going to do now?
Get a couple soldiers posted as lookouts to start. Understood.
Must be the gouge. don't mind. There's a lot of debris in the mountains. It's tucked in there during the flood. I'm gonna have to clear something to get inside. Time to head in. Okay, let's see where this leads. Take it easy. You must be Kintok.
Oh. I was an outlander, not my name.
Natika sent me to find you. The soldier you saved told us you were swept away by the mudslide.
So, he made it. Good. And Natika, she came back?
Yeah. She was on her way back to talk to you when the mudslide happened. She's looking after the survivors now.
It was my mistake to deny her discharge. A soldier is supposed to sacrifice for the good of the tribe. Looking back now, she was right. I didn't want to let her go. The chief's guard will gain an invaluable soldier. At least after all this, I won't be in the way anymore. I can tell you know a fatal wound when you see one. My service to my clan is done. So, leave me.
No, you're not going to die down here. There has to be a way to get you out.
There isn't. I tried to climb out. It's no use. The walls are too slick.
Water's coming in. From the surface? And not from where I came in. There must be another source. And if I find it, and open it up... You might not be able to move, Kintok, but I think there might be a way to move you. Hey. Hey! I need you to stay awake. I'm gonna take a look around.
You're just like Natika. Relentless as a fireclaw.
And you should be used to it. Just sit tight. I'm going to get you out of here. That waterfall must be coming from somewhere. I need to get out to figure out where it's coming from.
Refreshing.
Water's coming from that vent. Dead end. There must be another source.
Thank you.
There's some metal in that wall across the way. Might be able to pull some of it out. Try further back. Okay. The waterfall I saw down below should be coming in from somewhere around here. Gotta find its source. Water's coming in from there. I can use the fire gleam to break open that wall. This should flood. A way out. Almost there. Hey, stay with me.
Tell Natika.
You tell her yourself. She said you're a stubborn fighter, so keep fighting. Answers only to the hand that commands it.
He would say that every time we sparred. Sometimes as an insult. Other times as a compliment. But I guess he was right. It was always my choice to stay or go.
I'm sorry you didn't get to make amends.
So am I.
What will you do now?
I'm not sure. Bleeding Mark has a chance to recover. And once that's done, I could join the Chief's Guard, but I have to lay him to rest first. With full soldier's honors. Aloy, wait. You saved my comrades, somehow drained the entire village. I want you to have this.
Thanks. And good luck. Whatever you decide.
Blade be bright. Honor and strength.
Yeah. My squad's heading up.
I see soldiers guarding the wound in the sand. But no Yara. I need to see the wound.
I'm afraid your presence is required in the commander's quarters.
Is everything okay?
The dissident Draka has been apprehended for interfering with the wound.
How did he interfere?
He entered the wound by force, saw that it was empty, except for a slow trickle that began when you fixed the device in the desert. He did not take it well.
Of course he didn't. I'll go meet with them.
All strength to Hikaru's soldiers.
You have some nerve!
You're one to talk.
That doesn't sound good.
How could you let this happen?
How did I let this happen? You're the one who sabotaged the wound in the first place. You're lucky we were able to fix it, or your head would already be on a spear.
You call that fixed? It's just a dribble. And it's not my fault. I already told you Ukta came to me. He said he found something in the desert that might get us water. I had no idea it had anything to do with the wound.
And you expect me to believe that?
Aloy, I came for the water that was owed to us, and when I found out that there is no water, they arrested me.
As I already told you, the water is returning, but slowly. It'll be weeks before the wound is full again. Until then, I will send Arrowhand what I can.
You hid what happened to the wound. How can we believe you now?
Draka.
No, you know what? Enough of this! No more words! Consider that a challenge!
Gather your squads, then, and meet us at the Gate of the Vanquished. I have a challenge to prepare for. Leave me!
This will be the end of the clan. I I have to stop it. We have to stop it.
Hold on a second. Help me understand. What is this gate?
The doorway to a dead cauldron. A symbol of what the tribe aspires to. The defeat of deranged machines.
Dead? What shut it off?
No one knows. But it is a place of great significance for our clan. Even greater now, since it will mark the onslaught of a massacre.
What do you mean, the end of the clan?
Both sides will take their most loyal squads to the Gate of the Vanquished. Then they'll butcher each other as part of a ritual challenge. But it won't stop there. Whoever wins will try to wipe out the loser's loyalists all over the desert. The fighting could last for months. Those two scab heads are going to doom us all.
Can't you stop them?
I'm a chaplain. I provide counsel. I cannot force them to heed it. Even Chief Akaro can't intervene. It is a matter for the clan alone.
What makes you think I can help you stop them? I'm not even from this tribe.
They both owe you a debt. You aided them when no one else could. And you've seen into their hearts, just like I have. Misguided in different ways, but no less worthy of the people they protect. Your words might be enough to spear some sense into them.
Yeah, well, they're not exactly good listeners.
And you are no ordinary speaker, especially with a bow in your hand. I will go to the Gate of the Vanquished, southwest of here, to stall them. But without you, I'm afraid we'll run out of body bags fast.
Outlander. The craft of the Tanakh awaits you here.
Your trade is welcome, Outlander.
Good finishing touch.
Hey, stranger. Are you looking to trade?
I'm the favorite. Fine piece, if I say so myself.
That should help you stand out.
In battle or trade, it's good to have an ally. Hey! Honor and strength.
Be guided by the tech.
Here, your weapon can be sheathed. Trade and trust.